it's enabling a whole new range of science that was simply not possible before it arrived.
I am very excited about using Summit because this can help us solve problems which I have not been able to. I always wanted to in the past, and actually nobody in fusion research was able to solve.
There are literally things that we were dreaming about a year ago that are now not speculation, not pipe dreams, but things that we can actually do on Summit.
On Summit, there's a lot of memory on the node, and it's also coherently shared across the GPUs and CPU processors on the machine. And so this means that instead of simulating a few tens of atoms, we'll be able to simulate hundreds of atoms. And this is the kind of complexity that we need to simulate the properties that we care about.
So my team and I have been developing artificial intelligence solutions to enable comprehensive monitoring and deeper understanding of cancer outcomes at the population level. We are leveraging the compute power on Summit to explore an even larger number of possibilities in a much shorter time. So what Summit gives us is an acceleration in the experimental design and discovery.
Our major focal point is turbulent reacting flow as it applies to propulsion and power systems. Not only does Summit enable us to enhance the detail of the physics we get from our solutions, it also helps us to quantify the accuracy of those solutions with very specific error bounds.
We're computational stellar astrophysicists, and we're mostly interested in how stars live their life, the last part of their life, and how they die. There's so much physics going on in a star that is roughly the size of the Earth's orbit, for example, but we need to sometimes resolve processes that are going on microscopic scales. The sheer size of Summit will allow us to make very, very high resolution models.
This tenfold boost in performance is a big deal. An order of magnitude makes things possible that simply weren't before.